SABC News reporter Mbalenhle Mthethwa is standing by with an update for us. A very good afternoon to you, Mbalenhle. You're in Sandton, the memorial service set to start in just over an hour. What are you seeing around you?
Well, certainly we are seeing preparations continue as we draw closer and closer to the starting time. We've seen longtime friend and fellow musician Kuli Chana also just assisting with all the preparations. We have tried to speak to him. We tried speaking to him on Sunday, and we might be able to speak to him later on. Now, these were very close friends, and it would be very interesting and very nice to hear what he would have to say about their friendship and, you know, some of the conversations that would have happened behind closed doors that no one else would have been privy to. But as we are also here, we're seeing more people coming in, and as you know, that there's a lot of work that comes into or goes into, you know, making an artist. You know, there's the music, there's, you know, all these other things that we are not aware of, that we, when we look at an artist, we just see the performance and never really the people in the background. Similar to, you know, what we're doing here, people don't always see the people in the background. And the reason I'm saying this right now is that I'm joined by someone who says that they assisted in terms of, you know, the music in the background. I'm joined by Tabiso, who is also a friend who goes by the name DJ Fanatic, and he's also just going to give us a sense of their relationship. Thank you so much for speaking to us, Tabiso. And we appreciate you making the time to speak to us. Talk to us about, you know, what your relationship with Kiernan Forbes, especially in its early days.
You know, me and Kiernan, we met 2009. I mean, outside of me being his DJ for the longest time, he became a brother to me, you know. So it wasn't just about work, but it was also about brotherhood, friendship. I mean, it was like family to me, you know. So it's really heartbreaking what happened to him, and I don't think the country will have anyone in the hip-hop industry like how he was, you know. So yeah,
certainly, you know, when we were speaking off camera, you spoke about how you worked together and you were his DJ. Talk about the intimate details of your relationship, but talk to us about what does it mean to be a DJ to an artist like AKA, and some of the work that you did together.
You know, it takes a lot, especially for a person like him who was really, you know, invested in his craft. He knew what he wanted, very musical guy, and it's not easy. It's really not easy, because there are a lot of things that you guys come across, disagreements on the direction of how the performances need to go. But within that, we never lost, you know, the whole idea of what we wanted to achieve. So it's not an easy thing to do, but if you love it, like how I loved working with him, it becomes very easy. Yeah.
So what does a DJ do? I mean, you know, I was just talking about the people in the background, you know. Talk to us about the kind of work that you then did when you guys were working together.
We'd plan like, you know, performances like to the T, like what song comes after which one, and even create like new mashups, edits where the song has been changed differently. I mean, sounds differently, but people can actually recognize the song. So a whole lot goes into that, you know. We've worked on a numerous, you know, performances that some of them go down in history, you know, like how we did the Kanye West, we did Rick Ross, we did a whole lot, you know. There's just too many of them to mention.
Certainly, it sounds like you've had a very long relationship. Now, just off air, you spoke about the intimate details of that relationship, and sometimes even, you know, the early days, the time that you spent at Kiernan's home. Talk to us about that.
I mean, when he was still staying in Norwood with his mother, you know, I'd leave Fosloris, pick him up, would go to like meetings together. If it's late night, I'd crash on the couch, you know, then go back home on the following day, because that's how the family accepted me, you know. Because the early like days that we really connected, me and him, where we didn't have anything. And it goes to show that besides what people see on social media, how they never got to meet Kiernan Forbes. Instead, they see AKA, you know.
And what would you say is your fondest memory of him?
I think my fondest memory, it's just too many. I think definitely the earlier days when, it's just too many to mention. I can't even, recall one, but I think every single moment that I spent with him, I will cherish it for the rest of my life.
Thank you so much for speaking to us. There you have it. That one of AKA's longtime friends talking about their relationship and the times they spent together, talking about the time they spent at Kiernan, AKA Forbes' mother's home after gigs and in preparation for various gigs that they then went to. And also speaking about some of the work they did together and the artists that they worked together with and the work that they concluded together. It's back to you in studio.